So, Norman, how are you feeling right now?
I feel like I don't have a purpose after the war.
I see. So, why do you think that you feel this way?
Oh, you see, I served in the war. And once I got back, things were never the same.
Okay, so I want to kind of expand on that a little bit. So, you said that you got back from the war. What things were different when you came back from the war?
After I got off the war, you know, things were different as in, like, all the way to, like, I don't want to order fast food. Things are different. I did it wrong.
Yeah, I can see how things would be different for you. So, how do you feel like you're dealing with this change, since it's obviously really affecting you?
I don't want to do anything. I just drive my dad's truck around.
See. Well, how's your relationship with your family?
It's not that great, but that's the kind of person that wants me to get recognition for everything I do, medals, all that.
I see. So, would you say that your family's, like, proud of you and what you've accomplished, or?
I'm not really sure. I do everything I do can to make them happy. I'm gonna try my best.
I see. So, do you think that you have somebody, either like a friend or outside of your family, somebody that you can talk to whenever you need somebody?
No, not really. I don't have any friends in town anymore. They all are in the war, other cities.
I see. So, to try and make up for that loss in friends, have you ever considered maybe joining a program or something like that, where you can kind of like talk with other people, do activities, maybe sports, things like that? Well, something that I think a lot of people that I've talked to have done is they've joined programs like the YMCA, where you can go play basketball, exercise, swim, do whatever, and you can talk to the people. They're all really nice, and I would definitely recommend something like that.
I like the idea. I'm actually a big basketball guy myself, so I'm going to try that.
Sounds like a good fit.
It does.
Thank you.